One of the big questions remaining is how the Brexit will affect the UK, the fifth largest economy in the world. Earlier today, I sat down with Swati Dhingra. She's an economist at the London School of Economics, and she has been studying the potential impacts of the Brexit ever since the referendum was announced.
It's not theoretical anymore.
Oh, absolutely not. It was never theoretical, but now I think it's, earlier it was a possibility, now it is a reality. Just to give you sort of ballpark numbers of what we think the impacts would be. So in the next 5 years after a Brexit, we should expect GDP to decline by about 1 to 3%. 1% decline in British GDP means £720 lower income per household per year. Mm. And this is a permanent effect that you will see. So these are not trivial effects. These are going to affect the lives of people, their economic prosperity, and especially those of young people who will be entering the job market now.
You said that there's going to be costs to people that are entering the job market now. What are those?
So what we know from sort of work which has mainly been done for the US, that during economic downturns, the cohort that's entering the job market at the time, so say think of young college graduates, they tend to earn lower wages that year, of course, because there's just lower demand in that year. Mm-hmm. So wages are more depressed, and that's about a 6 to 8% drop in wages if you enter during an economic downturn. By economic downturn, I mean there's 1% higher unemployment than usual.
Okay.
And that effect doesn't go away. There are large, persistent negative effects on wages of young college graduates if they enter during a downturn. Even 15 years afterwards, they have 2.5% lower income. So in that sense, these are persistent effects which stay with the younger population, and they're the ones who are going to be growing up with that. Within the UK, I think what is also really important is that the life of universities is going to be under threat. When at the moment, what the UK has with the rest of the European Union are these programs to have exchanges, and they're very, very active programs. Mm-hmm. Those are going to come into question.
Does this make it harder for employers to recruit?
We're already seeing that happen. As the uncertainty develops, I think people are going to be on this hiring freeze, and it is going to have an impact on the pool of skilled workers available in the country. At the moment, if, say, you're a legal firm, you can hire any lawyer from anywhere in the EU. That pool is going to get much smaller, and that is going to impose costs on businesses in terms of who they're able to hire. I've done small business forums too, and they're very concerned about this issue as well, that if you wanted to, say, recruit teachers, are you okay with now suddenly hiring an EU immigrant teacher? And how about these English teachers who go to Spain? I think all of those things have already started happening.
Professor Dhingra also told me something else interesting. She said university systems around the UK are also going to have to figure out what happens if a large source of their revenue, meaning students coming from the EU, starts to slow down. Tomorrow, we're going to take a look at immigrants who've come here to work and how uncertain they are about their futures because of this referendum.